Perfect.
Yeah, hiding in my sock, hiding in my sock, staring every rock. First I park my car, then I pull the walk.
Washington State hosting Wazoo. Stanford. Luke Falk throws a touchdown pass to Renard Ball. Ooh. Bell. But look at the fan.
Coleman.
Forget the security. I'm coming over the barrier.
Whoa.
Oh, no, he didn't. Oh, come on, man. Did you really? Oh,
who
no, he didn't.
That?
Let's take a flashback to 2005.
Oh, what?
Uh-oh. There I am. There I am, mama. There go that man in Lambeau Field.
The stinky load out
I'ma tell you what, Washington State fan, you're not the only one.
Well, officials have had their moments this year. First, referee Von Torberger getting fired up for the game. Okay. Official Pete Morelli makes a call facing the wrong way. The referees won a measure, but the ball is 2 yards short of the first down. Questionable. But worst of all,
this is the best.
The field goal is wide right, but one ref signals no good, and the other signals good. Just turn to your left. Get on the same page. Come on, man.
Start with the opener. It was the Denver Broncos and the Baltimore Ravens. Joe Flacco's pass going to be intercepted by Danny Trevathan. He's headed for a touchdown, but flashback a couple of years, DeSean Jackson from Donovan McNabb, and just before he crosses the goal line, we're gonna slow it way down, he flipped the ball before he crossed the goal line. Danny Trevathan did the exact same thing, so I'm not gonna tell you, I'm gonna let DeSean Jackson be the one to tell you.
Come on,
this year, come on, man. Packers muffed the Titans punt. Watch Valentino Blake. He's pointing the wrong way.
This is your guy, man.
Come on, Blake. This way. And then the next week, Blake's at it again. The Titans receiving the punt. Ball bounces inside the five. Blake pins his own team against the goal line, catching the ball at the two. But there's more.
He's
Martin
contagious.
Wilson drops a touchdown, and then he kicks the ball. Well, you see where he kicked the ball, but look who's covering him. Blake, come on, man, for three straight weeks. It was contagious.
UCLA hosting Oregon. Bolu Olorunfunmi. Olorunfunmi gets the handoff, sees a crease, and he attempts to hurdle into the end zone and goes over the top of his defender. Olorunfunmi leaps
up, onto
his shoulder pads. Come from north. Then we have Syracuse quarterback Eric Dungy doing his Bruce Lee.
Ooh.
Eric, be honest with me. Did you mean to actually try to leap? Or did you try to do the Bruce
White
Lee?
White man can't jump.
If you try to leap, but look at Olorunfunmi. Attack from not the sun.
It's not too
Don't
bad.
Be attack.
All right, guys, let's go to College Station, Texas, late in the fourth quarter. A&M needs a score, but the quarterback throws an interception on the LSU sideline. Coach Ed Orgeron gets a Gatorade bath, but wait! After review, the quarterback's knee was down, negating the turnover. Unfortunately for Coach O, the Aggies got some time. They force overtime. Not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, Charles.
Not
seven overtime.
Sound like the Miami Beach.
Drenched in Gatorade, and guess what? LSU lost. A&M.
Check out Week 16, the Rams versus the Seahawks. Check out the punter, Johnny Hector, putting the ball deep down the middle of the field, but then he wants to take a shot at Cliff Averill while he's not looking. That was real coward-like, but that's okay. Come here. I'm leaving you alone right now. Then later on in the game, he punts again.
Hey.
A little bit there. My homeboy knocked you out. I don't want him, man. I was just playing with you.
We finally in the playoffs, baby. But I tell you what, during the season, there was some bad special teams plays. Look at the Steelers kicker trying this behind the back, Hall of Gold, Potter, no look. Man, I gotta say, I've been playing football a long time. I never seen that. But look at the Jets. And watch the ball bouncing to the end zone on a kickoff return, son. You gotta cover that ball. We learned that in kickoff return 101. Get on the ball, man. This is unbelievable and unacceptable. You make the team on special teams.
Well, that was
in the frozen tundra, but we're gonna take this thing down to South Beach. My Oakland Raiders against the Miami Dolphins. They drop back for the Statue of Liberty play. Oh, wait a minute. That wasn't the Statue of Liberty play. That was a strip fumble. Marshall Newhouse. Man, you wasn't brought there to be a running back or receiver. Don't you put your hands on that football no more, man. Look at you in the air like
a helicopter.
Come on, man.
The mighty minds of Milford, Massachusetts, boom. It's been the year of dance and Cam Newton. Now the coach is not even coaching football. They coaching a dance class. And homie going for a touchdown. The kids don't even care about football no more. Everybody dancing. The game then gone to the dogs and the kids. Everybody dabbing.
The best from college, Arizona versus Arizona State. Brandon Dawkins runs right into Mrs. Arizona. Look at this play right here. Hey, Miss Arizona, I'm sorry. Give me the number. We can go out to get something to eat after this. Hold on, I'm going to take a little time. Boy, get up off of me.
That's inappropriate.
Boy, get up off of me. I'm talking about watch on this kickoff. Watch the girl behind in the end zone. We've been asking about her all season. Oh. First name I know was Ashley. Ashley, I'm glad, sweetheart, you made our segment, but you made plays of the year. Y'all two, come on, man.
College, y'all gonna love this one. Louisiana Tech taking on Mississippi State. The snap goes by the quarterback, Jamar Smith. It keeps going. It keeps going. And it keeps going. The home run resulted in a third and 93 for the Bulldogs from their own 7-yard line. Louisiana Tech, are you kidding me? Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Let's take it up to Lambeau. Packers hosting the Ravens. Alex Collins takes the handoff. Mike Daniels is there first. Spins him around, takes him down to the and waits for the cavalry to come. Mike Daniels is excited. But maybe he's a little too excited. Look at his pants. It's Mike Daniels, pants. Do you have to go potty? No, because I already did. Mike Daniels, come on. Oh, man, let's take it to the Bengals and the Browns. Hugh Jackson is with the Bengals now. Andy Dalton tosses the ball to Demaryius Randle. But look what Demaryius Randle does. He hands the ball to Hugh Jackson. But Hugh Jackson, this ain't Christmas, and Demaryius Randle ain't Santa Claus. That is a lump of coal. But Hugh Jackson ain't done. After the game, hey, Baker, come here, man. Let me give you some love. Man, hold on, man. Let me stick this Heisman on you, Baker. Look at that Heisman stiff arm. Keeps Hugh Jackson at a distance like, man, hold on. I only love the guys in my locker room, and you are no longer in the locker room. Hugh Jackson, come on, man.
Football, Staunton River High versus Sir Patrick Henry High. Check out this quarterback. There was a no-look rain pass, touchdown. Talk about digging into the playbook. Where'd you go? Hoosiers? Is that Ollie? Staunton River High, well done.
Who's the offensive
Sir Patrick Henry High, how are you going to let this score on you? Come on.
Let's stay right there because we know Peyton Manning. What a night. 7 touchdowns against the reigning Super Bowl champs. But take a look at the headline in the Columbus Dispatch after the game. Elway throws 7 touchdown passes. Are you kidding? The last time he played for the Broncos.
You scary cat. Come on, man.
Week 6, Colts Patriots. The Colts ran one of the most unusual plays in history. Watch this. The fake punt. The Colts. They've got 2 players lined up in an unfavorable look against fake punt.
What?
They snapped the ball. It's impossible. You can't do what they did. It's the stupidest play in the history of the game. Come on, man.
Broncos, Bengals, Brock Osweiler intercepted by Dre Kirkpatrick.
100 yards is running.
He's like, yo, I'm going to take this all the way to the house. 101 yards, but he loses the ball. Kirkpatrick was able to recover it just short of the end zone. What is going on? He thinks he's got a pick 6, but he just can't hold on to the ball. Dre Kirkpatrick, ball security, the key, fellas.
Team Seahawks versus the Vikings, Cordarrelle Patterson. With a wonderful return, great speed, good eyes. And someone that I've known for 29 years would say, he could go all the way. Her ball is up, he's celebrating before he gets to the end zone, waving the arms, jump up in the stands. Helmet's gonna come off of him. Now we try to figure out what was the score. Was it tied at 35-35? Did he pull within 7, 35-28, or 35-0?
And if you guess C, 35-0, you are correct, Tom.
That is correct, E.
you
win.
The Chiefs
tonight in LA Coliseum. But this isn't the first rodeo in this stadium. Flashback 1971. 13-year-old Andrew Reed participated in the LA punt, pass, and kick competition.
Another
my JV coach at BYU. He was my quarterback coach, Matt. You can see that throwing motion. Why?
That's why
he was a great coach and why I was such a great player at BYU. Andrew Reed at the punt, pass, and kick. He grew up just down the street from the LA Coliseum. Look at that. He has a look, it's the same.
Panthers Buccaneers game. Graham Gano is looking to make a few warm-up kicks, and Bethune Cookman marching band is in the way, so he kicks that one. Then he decides he's gonna kick another one. But in the meantime, you know, he says, well, he's gonna shove a guy out the way. Now West Virginia, week five against Kansas, Mario Alford. Now look at this guy deciding to celebrate, but he doesn't have the trumpet with him. He's faking it with a
Saints hosting the Lions, Amir Abdullah. Gets the handoff and strapped in the backfield. Cameron Jordan grabs the jersey. Amir goes down, but whoa. We got to take another look at that. Boy, that looks like some type of magic trick. NFL authentic jersey.
Man, Division II FCS semifinals. Texas A&M Commerce, Vincent Hawk makes the catch.
Go.
He goes up. I know he didn't fall over the barrier. Look, this is the barrier that's supposed to keep the fans off the field. But where are the fans that you're keeping off the field? Oh, look in the back. There's a fan right by there, right near the fire truck. Y'all see him in the back? Are you serious about to get this man hurt? Come on.
High school football, Aloha Stadium. Kick up by Kahuku against St. Louis.
I don't know. Did you go?
Who? I don't know. Did you see it?
I don't know. Did you see it? Wait a minute. Let's talk about it. Was it good? Well, don't tell him. We don't want to know what the. Okay, well, what do you think? Well, wait a minute. Let me go ask. He's taking pictures back. Was it good? I hadn't really get it good. And boy, the kick was up. Good.
Quiet day for punters warming up. Rutgers punter Ryan Anderson takes a spill on it before he takes a kick. Then Ball State punter Morgan Haggy back to punt. He can't handle a snap, and he tries to kick it anyway, and he whiffs the kick. And then we have in Florida, Western Kentucky punter Jake Collins looks like he's trying to run a fake.
Fumbling.
The biggest mess I've ever seen in my life. Yeah. How could I spin it?
Not good for the brand, guys.
Internationally,
not
for a
good
touchdown
for the brand.
In honor of my best friend, Lee Johnson, who played in the league for 20 years.
All right, Blake Bortles. Hey, how about Jacksonville? What a great opener. Blake Bortles hits Allen Robinson. Nice completion out on the sideline. And blows out his left knee. Tragic. But Blake.
Not good.
Lee, no, not the knee.
Nope.
Don't. He just.
I'm not a doctor.
No. It's a blowout in favor of the Steelers, yeah. And some could say Carolina's defense was asleep. But defensive tackle Kyle Love, he might actually be asleep. Just like Keith Browner back in my Tampa Bay days, asleep on the bench.
Maybe he was
praying. Are we there yet?
Amen.
Man, we talking about rule changes. We need to change something. We need to do it fast. Cody Parker, his first PAT, hits the upright, his second PAT.
That's impressive.
And, hey, he is clinging this upright. Third field goal try. Clank the right side of the upright.
There's no way.
It can't be fourth try.
No way.
This is hard to
do. You think he's going to clank it?
Possible.
It's a magnetic ball.
Oh, my God. A National Football League. Just widen the goalpost just a little bit.
That's actually pretty good.
Hey, Cody Parker, come on, man.
Okay, how about now, Minnesota? We got mascots playing against little kids. Check out the Minnesota Golden Gopher trucking over a little kid. We've seen this before from the Golden Gopher mascot. Back in 09, he knocks over several players in this play.
Get out of the way.
Arms. What is going on? This is not right.
Even that's how Zeke go run tonight.
Colts mascot being a punk back in 14. Just bullying these kids. Leaping over the line of scrimmage like he's Troy Polamalu or something. Back to yesterday.
Oh, you got see, watch Steven Tolick here. He makes a sack, gets up, jumps up, celebrates, comes down, tears his MCL. Come on. Next week, the Bears, watch this guy. Lamar Houston sacks Brady, jumps up, tears his ACL. Both of them. Taylor ACL, never played another game the whole year. Come on, man.
Well, let's take it to the Meadowlands next. The New York Giants. Odell Beckham doing what he does, make a great circus catch, man. This dude is awesome. But you know OBJ loves the kids.
Oh, yeah.
He throws the ball to the kid. Wait a minute. Rewind that one more time. Man, that's the biggest eight-year-old I ever seen in my life. Now, you know good and well he wasn't throwing that ball to you. He was throwing it to that young man. Come on.
Come on, man.
We're going to make a decision. We're going to go for it. The Browns against the Jaguars. And no, we're not going to punt. We're going to have our team going. We're going to go for it on fourth and five. Kick, 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 kick. Get set. Kick, 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 kick. We planned all this. First of all, they didn't snap it in time, but they let it go anyway. You got to get 5 yards, and we did all that for this? But wait, there's more. Because you know that I can't do come on, man, without the Bucks. They wouldn't have beaten the Bengals. They got in position for the winning field goal. You want to know why they're holding the home? They had too many men on the edge. 12 men on the field. Of course, Lovey, the play was successful.
Let's take it to Norman, Oklahoma, the Sooner Spirit Squad, the Roughnecks celebrating the score. But look at this dude trying to show off his ab muscles, dragging behind the wagon. But wait a minute. Yeah, somebody help me up. It's getting a little hot. Help me up. Man, y'all got to find a better way to celebrate, Sooner Spirit Squad. Get the man in the wagon. Do it like you're supposed to do it. Come on, man.
You guys like kickers, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, everybody, yeah.
My favorite.
Nebraska, Ohio State, Caleb Lightborn kicking off for the Cornhuskers. But as you see, the kick goes absolutely nowhere. Oh.
Backwards?
Not exactly yet.
The kick
goes backwards. A day to forget for Caleb Lightborn. Come on, man.
I got this soda. Remy